so I can tell you there's no place we couldn't go. Just put your hand on the glass, I'll be counting for you through. You just gotta be strong. I don't wanna lose you now. I'm looking right at the other half of me. They can see the set in my heart. There's a space and now you're home. Show me how to fight now. I'll tell you, baby, it was easy coming back into you once I figured it out. You were right here all along. It's like you're my mirror. My mirror staring back at me. I couldn't get any bigger with anyone else beside of me. And now it's clear as a promise that we're making two reflections into one. Cause it's like you're my mirror. Ooh. My mirror staring back at me, staring back at me.
Together Anne and Kristian in holy marriage. which is an honorable estate, instituted of God and signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence at a wedding in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but discreetly and with reverence for God. It is into this holy estate these two persons come now to be joined. Anne and Kristian, I require and charge of you both, as you stand here in the presence of God, before whom the secrets of all hearts are disclosed, that having duly considered the holy covenant you are about to make, you do now declare before this company your pledge of faith, each to the other. Be well assured that if these solemn vows are kept, unviolated as God's word demands, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your heavenly Father, God will bless your marriage. He will grant you fulfillment in it, and he will establish your home in peace. The Apostle Paul wrote in his first letter to the Corinthians, "If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. Love is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophecy is imperfect, but when the perfect comes, the imperfect will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall understand fully. So faith, hope, love abide, these three, but the greatest of them is love." Kristian, will you have Anne to be your wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, keep yourself only to her so long as you both shall live. If so, say, "I do."
I do.
And will you have Kristian to be your husband, to live together in a holy estate of matrimony? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, keep yourself only to him, so long as you both shall live. If so, say, "I do."
I do.
Who presents this woman to be married to this man?
I, Stephen, her father, and my wife, Lori, her mother.
Most of you, probably all of you, know a little bit about the circumstances under which Anne and Kristian met each other and how their relationship developed over a number of years, actually. About 4 years. And that they met through the internet and that obviously Kristian was living in Finland and Anne was living here in the United States, and they were both very much involved in playing a game which I know nothing about, absolutely nothing about, except that a whole lot of people from all over various places in the world can all participate in this. But with all of these hundreds and I guess potentially thousands of people who are involved in this, you can begin to develop relationships and alliances with other people, and you can develop ways of helping each other. And as that relationship develops, the quality of the communication between the players can become more and more personal and private and, dare I say, intimate? I guess you'd have to ask Anne and Kristian about that. I wouldn't presume to know. But this I found fascinating. You know, somebody told me 20 years ago I was going to do a wedding ceremony for two people who met on the internet and had not met face to face for about 3 years before they did, and I would say, you're free. Of course, when I was a young pastor, there wasn't such thing as the internet, so I guess I really would have been that way. Now, you might think that this is kind of a strange circumstance, but in actuality, what I would like to suggest to Anne and to Kristian, but to all of us, because, you know, there's no way I'm going to teach these two guys anything at this point. You know, the deal is done, right? So I'm not up here talking to them. I'm talking to you all out there, right? That this idea of meeting in this way is really not so strange after all. The foolish person is the person who comes to their wedding day and says, I know everything there is to know about the person that I'm marrying. I know the depths of their heart. I know their personality inside and out. I know what their dreams are. I know what they're going to be like 40 years from now. If anybody in this room has been married more than a couple of months, you know that that is total, utter nonsense. You don't know each other when you marry. You know something about each other, but you don't know where this relationship is going to lead you. And so this is really a rather normal kind of thing to be happening here today. Anne and Kristian come together knowing that they share certain values, certain interests, certain passions, certain desires, certain goals, but there's a lot about each other that they don't know. And only time will reveal what those things are. Personally, I think they're both very brave people. It's going to be a steep learning curve for both of you. I can identify more easily with Anne moving to Finland because there's language, there's culture, there's food, there's, I don't know, you don't drive on the left-hand side of the road in Finland, do you? Actually, I knew that. I was just trying to be funny. There is a lot that Anne's going to be learning, but don't fool yourself, Kristian. There is a lot that you're going to be learning too, even though you're going to be home in Helsinki where you know every street corner probably. So the learning curve is going to be steep, but hopefully it's going to be exciting and it's going to be full of love. Anne requested a particular scripture that be read, and I'm going to conclude my message by reading that. But before I go ahead and read it, I'd like just to share a thought about it. The ancients, the Greeks these were, had three different words for love. Eros, philos, and agape. Three different kinds of love. The passage that I'm going to be reading uses the word agape for love. But the difference between those three words has a lot to do with how Anne and Kristian live their life and how we all live our lives together, whether married or unmarried, whether with family or without. Eros is the kind of love that comes from impulse and need and desire. Eros is about me. Eros is about loving that which satisfies my impulses and fills my needs and quenches my desires. Philos, on the other hand, is a different kind of love. Philos is about the other person. It's brotherly love, the word from which Philadelphia comes. And that's the love that meets your needs. So if I have filial love for you, I'm interested in what your needs and your wants and your desires are. But what is agape? Agape is a kind of love which is neither eros nor philos. Agape is love for us. Agape is about us. It's not what's good for Kristen. It's not what's good for Anne. It's not what's good for Fred or what's good for Fred's wife, Sue, although sometimes she thinks it is. Agape is not what's good for you. It's what's good for you in the plural. What's good for you together. What's good for us. And I think that as a couple together in the years to come, you are going to find a lot of surprises around the corner, because you're going to discover that what's good for you as a couple is going to be something that's totally undreamed of, totally different than what's good for you as individuals. And I pray God's blessing on you as you seek what is good for you as a couple. And now I'll conclude by reading that passage from the letter of 1 John. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and he who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. In this the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world, so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the expiation of our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No man has ever seen God. If we love one another, God abides in us, and his love is perfected in us.
I, Kristian, take you, Anne.
I, Kristian, take you, Anne.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us apart.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I pledge you my faith.
And thereto I pledge my faith.
I, Anne, take you, Kristian.
I, Anne, take you, Kristian.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I pledge my faith.
And thereto I pledge my faith.
Thank you.
The wedding ring is the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of this man and woman in holy matrimony through the Church of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let us all pray together. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may abide in your peace and continue in your favor through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
In token and pledge,
in token and pledge,
of our constant faith,
of our constant faith,
and abiding love,
and abiding love,
with this ring I thee wed,
with this ring I thee wed,
with all that I am,
with all that I am,
and all that I have,
and all that I have,
I wish to honor you,
I wish to honor you.
So this ring is a sign,
so this ring is a sign,
of my unending devotion,
of my unending devotion
and commitment to you,
and commitment to you.
For as much as Anne and Kristian have consented together in holy marriage and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have pledged their faith each to the other and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together. Let no one put asunder. Pray with me. We pray for these two young people as they venture out together to form an entirely new thing, a marriage, a family, as they come to know each other, and perhaps as their relationship blesses others. We pray that you will bless them with health, with strength, with ambition and vitality, that their lives might be a living witness to the love that you have for us all. These things we ask in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who taught us each to pray in his own way the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We're going to conclude by singing the hymn entitled Be Thou My Vision.
Thank you.
bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord graciously with his favor look upon you, and so fill you with all spiritual benediction and love, that you may so live together in this life, that in the world to come you may have life everlasting. Amen. Kristian, you may kiss your bride. And Anne, you may kiss your
Kristian Boulder. We by being present in spirit in the ceremony among you through this letter, we pass our congratulations to the happy couple. We are sorry that we could not physically present here, but to Anne and Kristian, I would like to say that for sure in spirit we are present here with you. Anne and Kristian, you are still very young and you have taken a major step in your life today, a greater responsibility than you do realize. You have shown the kind of tenacity and courage which is a model for many of us. I wish and believe that with your love and care you will make through the trials and difficulties. Those are also a part of your future life. We wish you a long and happy life, life that is bound with love, understanding and support of each other. You have got your whole life ahead of you, a life that feels now seeming endless possibilities, dreams and hope. As your parents, we were once in the same situation, but it seems like yesterday. But now, we are here in this unique and great ceremony of Anne and Kristian. So let us raise a toast in honor of the lovely couple. They deserve it. Congratulations once again, Anne and Kristian.
Subtly too many times to not say it, so that's okay. Well, good job, you two. Congratulations, and may God bless your lives to be long and happy, because you deserve all of the happiness. Also, fun story about the pterodactyl. So when I think I was like 12 or something. That's the awkward age, right? 12? Okay, we're gonna say 12. So I figured she'd get married one day, and I said, when you get married, I'm going to get you an ice sculpture of a pterodactyl. So last semester of college, I was looking everywhere, inquiring everyone, like, hey, could you make me an ice sculpture of a pterodactyl? And they're like, yeah, for $800. And I'm like, no. So then I looked at my next option of a glass sculpture pterodactyl, and literally I've looked everywhere. There's no one in the United States that I know who has a website that says I will make you a hand-blown glass figurine, specifically the pterodactyl. But that didn't happen. So plan C was, I just need a pterodactyl, and I found the pterodactyl. So there you go. Once again, congratulations, Mrs. Anne Victoria Walter at Sibley Morton.
Thanks. She says that was a toast. Well, I can't believe I'm here. Wow. You blink your eyes and 25 years goes by. And there's lots of drip that I could add to all of this stuff, because you've heard probably a million and one father's toasts to the bride and groom. So I'll keep it short and sweet. I wish Kristian and Anne the best and most happy fun and adventureful life that they can have, traveling wherever they travel, on the other side of the world or back home, to propagate our families, to have lots of grandkids, and let us be part of that so we can spoil them. Because I've told them lots of times, in all of the confluence of time and space throughout eternity, there's only one moment like this, and there's only one Anne, and there's only one Kristian. So I toast to their eternal happiness. All right, thank you. What we're going to do is we're going to have dessert shortly, and then we're going to begin the party. Bright lights and all.
There you stand, open heart, open doors, full of life with a world that's wanting more. But I can't see when the lights start to fade.
You know that even though it seems like life has been forever, it is so short. I am really the luckiest man on earth because I had you for one thing. I thought my life was everything it could ever be, and then having you and raising you as a child, going through all the things that you've gone through, encouraging you, coaching you, getting to be proud of you, seeing all the wonderful things you've done. I know it's just but a taste of all of the good things yet to come. You and your life with Krisu are going to be the most wonderful part of your life just unfolding you. Every day will be different and new. Every day will be special. Every day will be wonderful. Take the time to enjoy it. Do not worry about anything, but just roll with everything that happens and make the best of everything. Find the best in everything. And I know that my life is fulfilled because your life will be wonderful. Long after I'm gone, you'll still be there. You'll be going on for our family's sake. And more importantly, you'll be able to give all of the gifts that I hope to give to you, to your children and your descendants someday. And for that, I could not be happier. So I wish you and Krisu the best. And as life goes on, I hope to be as much a part of it as I can be. But remember, it's your life and your happiness, and I know you will have lots. Thanks for being a wonderful daughter.
Congratulations to Anne and Krisu. Hope that both of you will have a successful marriage. Be nice to each other, give and take, you know. And I wish you all the best in the world. See ya.
Yellow diamonds in the light, and we're standing side by side as a shadow crosses mine. What it takes to form a life.
Fun tonight. Right now the Cupid Shuffle is playing and you're doing that, so that's pretty cool. But I want you to have lots of fun and lots of happiness in Finland, but I also want you to come home safely to me, because I am going to miss you dearly. It's just not the same without you. So I don't know what else to say, but that's it. Husband of yours beats you up or anything or does anything, I'm gonna beat him up. I'm gonna go over to Finland, gonna beat his butt, take you back here.
Plane.
We're gonna go on a plane. I don't know how or when. We'll get the money and we'll come
we'll
on.
Make it happen. Don't
we'll
worry.
Make it happen. But congratulations anyway.
We love you.
Yes. But
and
still.
Yeah. If you've ever, you know, need anything, don't hesitate.
Call us.
Doesn't matter that I'm over here. Doesn't matter what time of the day, I don't care.
You call us.
Yeah.
If you don't call us, we'll find you.
Yeah.
Something.
Okay.
Do your dream before your husband.
Oh, that's
true. Congratulations.
Yeah, that's true.
Your dreams.
But still,
I'll work on his later. It's okay.
But still, I will kill him if he does anything.
Just letting you know.
Give me a call.
Yeah.
Call me maybe, you know.
Yep. Well, this ain't no song.
It is now.
Okay, well, then it is a song. Let's see. Other than that, you better eat food. Eat food? Wow.
Eat your basic food group.
Eat your basic food group.
Go to, you know, see a doctor regularly. You know, typical stuff. Don't
get a mammogram.
Me...
I don't know. We might as well just toss it all up in there.
Get the whole spiel. Don't make me come over there and have to take you somewhere.
Just be happy.
Be yes. healthy and happy and
everything else.
Call me. Yeah. Text me. I don't care.
Call me maybe.
Call me maybe.
Let me see.
Get out here.
Yeah.
You.
I don't know.
Get. All right.
Okay.
That is it.
This is the garter toss. Where are all the single men? We gotta find that garter. Where is it? Where is it? Did you find anything? Oh, we got one. Okay. Now, one and a two and a three. And
okay, cousin Anne and new cousin Kristian, I just want to say that I'm really happy for you guys, and no matter how love is found or how love is sustained, it is always true and should never be judged. I hope you two have a beautiful life. I'm really happy for you to enjoy the life in Finland, and God bless you.
You know, we've been cousins forever. That's what that means. You know, you've also been a really great friend to me. I'm going to be sad that you're going to Finland for a while. I'm going to see you for a while, but I'll try to keep in touch. Have lots of fun with Kristian. I'm sure you will. You've always, you know, had fun. And good luck in your endeavors.
Well, Anne and Kristian, I wish you the best of luck. You guys have just the uncanny ability of just making family out of whatever friends you guys make. And just remember, you always have family all around Chicago, the States, and the world. Just, if you ever need anything, you know that there's somebody that you could always talk to. So, good luck.
Anne and Kristian, congratulations. Thank you for having us. Be part of your very special day. And, I want to wish you a wonderful life together. You have a very bright future, both of you. And I hope that you decide to move back to America. So, God bless you, and we'll see you soon, hopefully. Thanks.
Muistan, kuinka en kun tuli Suomeen, mentiin yöllä tanssiin. Miten hauskaa oli kaikilla. Yes.
Okay. So, Anne. We have now known each other since 2004, so that makes it 11 years now. And I have known you through so much stuff. Like, just hard times, great times, going to state for choir, going to prom, which this reminds me so much of because you're just having so much fun. And I don't even know what to say to it. I've seen you in your lowest, and you've seen me in my low, and back and forth, but this is definitely the top of the tippy top, and I'm so glad you're happy, because everybody deserves to be happy, especially how happy you are, and especially you. And, well, Kristian, if you mess that up, I'm gonna kill you. I will find you, even in Finland. Well, I don't know. Cherish the day, honestly. It goes by so fast. And I'm going to really miss you when you're in Finland. I really hope that I get to go out there and see you. And I can't wait until you come back. And I don't know, maybe you'll have a couple of kids that I can spoil and be Aunt Jackie. You never know. But I look forward to seeing you grow with Kristian. And Kristian, I look forward to seeing you grow with her and making her twice the person she was before, even though she's the best person I've ever met. So I don't know how you can beat that, but you will, as a couple. Okay? Love you guys.
Gotta say congrats to Ann and Chris for basically a Cinderella story come true. It was such a wonderful romance when they met. We've had the pleasure of knowing them for a couple years.
Probably about three now, yeah.
Maybe, yeah, give or take. Just everything that I've known from them has just been love, and it's wonderful watching two people that love each other this much join each other in matrimony. I'm almost in tears thinking about it. But here's to, you know, a good first year of marriage and so much more to come. Congrats, you guys.
Yeah. It's just kind of hard to believe on that, really.
Yeah.
Two different ends of the world, really. It's kind of hard to believe that that's kind of where it ended.
We're in
one big step of marriage and going overseas to live into a foreign place. Kind of exciting and scary at the same time.
Yeah. It's just, it puts so much things in perspective, and it's just crazy. And it's just hard not to think the very best of them.
All the luck in the world.
Yeah.
Nothing, no secrets though. I can't say that.
Yeah, I don't really, can't
Sports
really spill anything,
no,
yeah.
I may have stole the guild funds though. But yeah, congratulations guys.
Congratulations, Chris.
I'm very happy that my brother go weddings and found Anne in so far, and it's amazing everything. I never think that my brother found someone like Anne, and it's confused because he's I'm older than him, and still he is first to go marriage. She knows her belt and knows how to
please. Show my pen now, cause you're a man. Kristian, I wish you good luck. And one advice I have is patience. And that will get you through anything and everything. And I will be seeing you in Helsinki next year. And I hope you are still doing well. Good luck.
Best wishes, Anne. We wish you the best of things, and we believe that you will make it into greatness.
Have fun.
Hi, Anne. And Kristian, enjoy your married life, and God bless.
Have fun.
What do you want to say?
Enjoy Finland.
Welcome to the family, Kristian.
Hi, Anne. This is Tito Ben and Tita Marlin, and Aries is Marvin in Marvelin. Best wishes to both of you, and Victoria and Kristian. If you guys need some, you know, anything, let us know. You know, we're family. So here's Tita Marlin.
Hello, Anne. And it's too fast. You are leaving already. We're gonna miss you. You are my very good. What's that? Niece. And we wish you best, the best of all, and best wishes and congrats to Kristian. Always love each other, okay? And here's Aries.
What can I say? You're married. You know, as a kid, it's been nice. It's been nice spending time with both you and Liz. However, I didn't get much of a chance to see you guys grow up. We never spent too much time together. However, you are moving on with your life and getting married, going to Finland. I don't know anything about Finnish culture, but props to you. It'll be a big challenge, like that pastor said. So, good luck to you. And you too, Kristian.
Best wishes. And Marbeline?
Just say best wishes.
Say best wishes.
Okay. All right.
Congratulations, Anne and Kristian. And assure to the new states of your life. I wish you luck and have a happy married life. All right.
Let's make this fleeting moment last forever. So tell me what you're waiting for. I'm gonna keep it frozen here forever. There's no regretting anymore. It's worth the wait, even so far away. I'm making the night mine until the day I die. No light to break when you're hanging by fate.
Following our dreams and being able to accomplish